Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. There was two earthquakes along the San Andreas Fault Zone near Soledad. One was a magnitude 3.5 earthquake, 5.9 kilometers in depth, which would be close to almost 4 miles in depth, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. Shortly afterwards, there was a magnitude 2.6. The 3.5 occurred at 11:56 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and the 2.6 was at 12:48 p.m. local time. Both of these earthquakes were south-dipping moving earthquakes. You can see here it moved towards the south and dipped down. This here is the 3.5, same thing. It moved south, the fault line moved south and dipped down. Most of the reports that were sent in, and there was only four that USGS is showing, it shows that the energy went south. That's where the earthquake reports came from, close to Soledad. And I'm going to talk a little bit about the San Andreas Fault Zone. Down over here is an area what they call a creep zone, much like what they have up there in Washington. Quiet earthquakes. Very small tremors in this location. It's locked and moves very slow. There's also another segment called the Green Line Creep segment. Geologists believe that this creep segment can help relieve the stress for a major earthquake. Well, evidently it didn't do that there. Here on Research Gate is an image of the different sections of the creep segment. We got creeping segment, Parkfield segment, and then a locked segment. That kind of close down to Bakersfield. Many of the earthquakes in this area have had a southern movement, the fault line moving south. This fault line moves about 21 to 26 millimeters a year. This creeping section is about 80 miles long, extends from San Juan Batista to Parkfield. See, this is that green zone. I don't know if you can see it. I'll bring it in. Can you see that green line that I got drawn out? Recently, they found out that the creep is not a steady creep, not consistent. It comes in bouts. So because of that, it puts stress on the two different locations, north and south, builds up more pressure, creating more of a potential of larger earthquakes. And in my opinion, because it's been moving south, yeah, that goes down towards Parkfield and Southern California. Here's another image from berkeley.ed showing the different sections of the San Andreas Fault Zone. Up here we got the zone that fractured from the 1906, they call it the San Francisco earthquake. Below the creep zone, which is in green, we have 1857, the Fort Teton earthquake. The line in black, geologists are really concerned because that has not had a large earthquake since the 1600s. And scientists know that that section is way overdue for an earthquake. Using USGS, here is the earthquakes that have occurred within the last week in this location. There is 15 of them. So I'm going to move down along the fault zone, see what else we might have along here in this locked zone. Yeah, look at that. All bare. Yeah, there's Greenfield. That's what it's named after. Yeah. This 1.6 was on the Green Line Creep segment. And then we got another one here, which is Parkfield segment, a 1.6. And a 0.3, also Parkfield, and you can see this is the area that's all locked, building up stress. See that? Absolutely nothing within the last week, according to USGS. Further down, there is a 1.2, that's the Grapevine. Another 1.2, and then a 1.4. That 1.2 was today, the 18th, The 1.2 that came after, that was on 17th, and then the 1.3 also. Oh, that's way down south. Forget that one. That was Palmdale. And let me see. Okay, the 1.4, that also was on the 14th. Anyways, did you feel this earthquake? I thought you might find this information a little interesting. If so, please put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. I hope many of you are prepared for a large earthquake if and when it decides to come. And like I said, Southern California, in that one zone, is way overdue for a major earthquake. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.